let's actually go a little big picture now for a minute. We know this takes 9 cycles. How long does a cycle have to be? As long as what?
The slowest instruction.
It's not the slowest instruction.
The one that takes the longer.
The what that takes the longest?
The stage.
It's the stage that takes the longest. Okay. Just look at this. This is cycle 5, right? Now, all this has to take place within 1 tick of the clock. What have I said fundamentally tons of times? A computer can only have 1 clock, right? So, whichever of these takes the longest time has to be the time of the clock tick. Okay? Now, using what you know about memory from the first unit, you can probably narrow it down to 2 staples. So, what's faster, RAM or registers? Registers are faster, right? So I can probably already guess that IB, which only uses registers, and write back, which also only uses registers, are going to be faster than IFetch, which uses RAM, and data memory, which uses RAM. Okay. Now, unfortunately, we have to use one of these times. We can't use one of these times, because all that has to take place in a clock cycle. So it's going to have to be the time of one of whichever of these takes the longest. I'm sorry, I said DM. Now, the only stage that's remaining is execute. The main components of execute are what? An ALU and an adder. You think that's going to be too slow? You built an ALU. All it was digital logic, ANDs and ORs, right? Digital circuits run very, very fast. Okay, that's probably going to be actually your fastest. Execute's probably going to be your fastest. Now these are fairly comparable, although this does have RAM and a register. However, instruction memories are typically smaller than data memories. Honestly, it's probably a toss-up. But fundamentally, it needs to be the time of the slowest stage. That's it. This was a little bit different from how we figured it out with the state diagram, right? Remember with the state diagram, let me actually pull that up. What did we do for the state diagram? Time of the slowest state. Here we're looking at the time of the slowest stage. Are those two the same? You know, remember, the whole point of building this pipeline design is that we wanted to improve on this, right? So, I mean, yeah, we've already seen the improvement, at least in terms of cycle counts. Okay, and that, I think we can be convinced of. Okay, the 5 instructions there took 9 cycles. How many would they have taken here? Okay, the add would have taken 1, 2, 3, 4. The sub would have taken 4. The load board would actually have taken 5, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 states. Sub would have taken 4. So 4, 8, 12, 17, 21. We went from 21 cycles here for those 5 instructions to 9 cycles in the pipeline. No argument there in terms of cycle count. But how about the time of the cycle? So here we already talked about, it's going to probably be the time of one of these. Let's look at the states here. So here we have this instruction fetch, which also uses instruction memory, right? So probably that time is going to be pretty comparable. Okay? So we probably didn't lose a lot on the time per cycle. But it will not be exactly the same, okay? That's something to take note of. So we have cycle count to consider, but also we have time per cycle. They won't necessarily be the same, they'll probably be comparable. Now, what are we really paying for with pipeline? We're not really paying in terms of the time per cycle, even though it could possibly be a little bit less, but not that much. The registers, okay? We're paying money. That's the real sacrifice you're making with the pipeline. Okay? And you can get an idea of how many registers you need just by looking at the insert. Every wire that crosses one of those boundaries, every one needs a register. Now, both of them have 32. At least. Right, so both of them have 32 here. But then here you got one here, one here, one here, one for your control signals, here, 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 okay? You're adding quite a few more, okay? You're adding quite a few more. So there is a cost associated with pipeline. Now, also, I want you to come away with some practical knowledge in terms of your processor speed. Or what? Actually, what are modern speeds now? I might be dating myself. Is it greater than 4 now? No, it's about 4 still. Okay. Last I heard, it was 4. Let's assume 4. All right. Now, what is this in terms of what we're measuring over here? Okay, 4 gigahertz is ticks per second, or you could look at it as cycles per second. Same thing. Turn that on its head. That's time per cycle, right? Cycles per second, just reverse it, it's seconds per cycle, time per cycle. So, is a 4 gigahertz processor always faster than a 3 gigahertz processor? Not necessarily, right? Because if the time per cycle is not the only thing that matters. You also want to look at the cycle count. Okay? The time per cycle probably is going to be lower with the multi-cycle hardware. Maybe not by a lot, but what did we just say? The time per cycle with the multi-cycle is the time of the slowest state, right? The slowest state is going to be probably iFetch again, and that one might be a little bit faster than my iFetch here. On paper, if you were to buy that multi-cycle computer, it's going to say the processor speed is faster. The pipelined architecture takes fewer cycles. It takes fewer, maybe slower cycles. But it's so much fewer that it's better. Okay. Don't just go on the gigahertz. Now, Manny, your LA, sent me a nice video that actually illustrated this concept well. So I do want to actually show this to you kind of as an end of class thing. You said it was about 8 minutes long, right?
8 minutes.
8 minutes long? Yeah. Okay. I will show that now because I think it's interesting and I think it's important to come away with this. This came out right around the year 2000. Now, this was when I was in college and I still had a megahertz processor. So when people started talking about gigahertz processors, everybody went crazy. Now, what he actually showed was that a processor that was, I think, was it 1.4 or 1.6 gigahertz?
I think it was
1.6
gigahertz.
1.6? Versus 800 megahertz, right?
Yeah.
So immediately to me, I would think that 1.6 gigahertz would be twice as fast as 800 megahertz, right? But it's not, and I want us to get an idea of why. It's a slightly different reason. Both were pipeline. Okay, I'm comparing a pipeline versus a pipeline. That one's a little more obvious than this one. But I want us to have a look at this.